Florence and the Machine has released a total of 5 albums in the span of a decade. The band combines the different elements of indie, folk, and baroque pop. Besides having one of the most captivating vocalists in indie music, they have consistently made their permanent stamp on the genre through thoughtful and impassioned lyricism. In today's video, we'll talk about the rise of Florence and the Machine as a band, their discography, and Walter's journey to sobriety. If you're a fan, please keep watching. Florence Welch's unfortunate struggles with addiction have influenced the melodic sound and the accompanying themes of her band, Florence and the Machine, which have become their trademark. Born Florence Leontine Mary Welch on August 28, 1986, she had always been encouraged by her paternal grandmother, Sybil, to pursue her musical talents. Her father, Nick, was an advertising executive, while her mother, Evelyn, was a Harvard-educated woman, later becoming vice chancellor of a major university. As a child, Welch participated in family functions and at school plays. By her teenage years, Welch wanted to do something else. She became vocal lead of a band called the Toxic Cockroaches. Upon dropping out of the Camberwell College of Arts, Welch dove headfirst into her musical aspirations. After a drunken singing encounter at the Solo Review Bar with Queens of Noise Murray Nash, Welch was invited back to open for club night. Formed 2007, alongside her friend Isabella Summers, the band went on to win the 2009 Brit Awards for their debut album, Lungs. The album was produced by James Ford, Paul Epworth, Steve Mackey, and Charlie Hugo. Lungs peaked at number 1 in the UK and number 2 in Ireland. The album features songs such as Rabbit Heart, Howl, Kiss with a Fist, and Dog Days Are Over. Upon its release, fans realized Welch was an inspired vocal talent, drawing comparisons to the likes of Kate Bush. Florence and the Machine married lyrics of torture poeticism, seeking to quell the scariness of death with the fortitude of rebirth and the stoic religious imagery that followed it, utilizing the taboo subjects that scare us, often ones of a metaphysical or intangible quality. In the United States, Long shot to number 17 on the Heartseekers chart. Their second album, Ceremonials, released on 31st of October 2011. In this album, Welch uses water imagery throughout the album. This theme can be heard on What the Water Gave Me. Welch evokes a sense of withdrawal from a crisis in love and relationship animus, really one that you won't want to let go of. Shake It Out was everyone's gothic mantra 2011. Florence and the Machine used tambourines, organs, and bells, receiving critical acclaim on behalf of Welch's vocal ability, drawing similarities to Annie Lennox and Madonna. At the 55th Grammy Awards, Shake It Out was nominated for the Best Pop Duo / Group Performance. When speaking about the song, she said, "I wanted to just shake something out. Shake out these regrets. Shake out these things that haunt you. It's one of those songs that came in about half an hour when you've got a hangover. It's almost like a hangover cure. You're like, thank you. I don't want everyone to think that I always write songs with a hangover, because I don't. I really don't. But with this one, I have to say there was a bit of one lurking in my mind as I wrote it. It was like I was trying to write a hangover cure." As an album, Ceremonials were produced entirely by the aforementioned Epworth. On the UK album's chart, it debuted at number 1 after selling over 94,000 copies in its first week. In 2013, the British phonographic industry certified Ceremonials as double platinum. During this time, the band recorded Breath of Life for the Snow White and the Huntsman film, starring Kirsten Stewart, Charlize Theron, and Chris Hemsworth. During this time, Welch even collaborated with Calvin Harris on his song Sweet Nothing. It quickly became her second number 1. In 2015, How Big, How Blue, How Beautiful was released. Tracks featured were somber and deeply personal. On February 16 of that same year, Florence Welch told Zane Lowe, "I was still going out and going to events, but something wasn't quite right. I was spiraling a bit. I wasn't making myself happy. I wasn't stable." The album showed Welch's inner reflection of her personal experiences. As much as each track showed vulnerability, they equally magnified her evolution as a songwriter, who was competent and talented. Welch explained the process as trying to learn how to live and how to love in this world, rather than trying to escape from it. One Kind of Man focused on a man's inability to choose a romantic relationship, centering around Welch's own experiences in her romantic life. Ship to Wreck was the drumming song singer's commentary on her self-destructive inclination. Perhaps one of my personal favorites of this album, Queen of Peace, was another single. All in All, How Big, How Blue, How Beautiful debuted at number one on the UK Albums Charts. In the US, the album debuted on the Billboard 200, with 137,000 equivalent units and 128,000 from pure album sales. For our content, I thought about making a video solely about this next album. However, I thought against the idea. In their catalog, Highest Hope is one of their more simplistic offerings for the way it deals with learning to be lonely, familiar connections, loss, and heartbreak. Released on the 29th of June, 2018, Florence Welch uses her talent as a capable songwriter to weave stories from memory about the things in her life she has worked to resolve. Those memories create feelings which are deeply human, stripped down and distinguished from her previous work as both a songwriter and an artist. In an interview with Universal Music, Welch recalled the themes on the album as, "There's loneliness in this record, and there's issues and pain and things that I struggle with. But the overriding feeling is that I have hope about them. And that's what kind of brought this title. I was going to call it The End of Love, which I actually saw as a positive thing, because it was the end of a needy kind of love. It was the end of a love that comes from a place of lack. It's about a love that's bigger and broader, that takes so much explaining. It could sound a bit negative, but I don't really think of it in that way." Here are some examples of what Welch is referring to. The track Grace was inspired by her younger sister of the same name. For Hunger, the singer harkened back to her battles with an eating disorder and alcoholism in her adolescence. And while Grace and Hunger are two of the album's best, every track speaks to the changing nature of life's seasons and the elimination of fear. In the US, Highest Hope was kept out of the top spot due to Drake's Scorpion album, unfortunately, but as of September 19, 2018, it had managed to sell more than 80,000 copies in the UK. With their fifth album, one of the leading singles was King, which was focused on Welch's conflict in choosing her career and family life, as well as current gender norms for cis women when they conform to society's expectations. Dance Fever reached commercial success in the United States and Australia. Specifically in the US, it debuted at number 7 on the Billboard 200 chart and was named one of the top alternative and rock albums in the country. The success of Florence and the Machine has never been more apparent than it is now, for themes and songwriting excellence exhibited by Florence Welch. Amid all of their success, Welch has been candid about her struggles with addiction. In 2019, her Vogue essay focused on relinquishing the power of past struggles with an eating disorder and addiction. She writes, "I tend to look back on that time with a mix of nostalgia and terror. There's a part of me that is in awe of that girl. Her total disregard for self-preservation. How she could run at the world head first, eyes closed, with no care for the consequences. But I also want to hold her in my arms and say, it's okay. You're okay. You can come down now. You've been screaming at the top of that tree for a bit too long." She continues, "I thought my relationship with food could never be normal. I believed it was damaged beyond repair. But I can honestly say I don't really think about it now. I don't diet. I don't fucking cleanse. I try not to think of any food as good or bad." As she puts it, she has learned to be successful despite demons, not because of them, while remaining a steady fixture in the indie genre, captivating fans with her singing voice and presence, managing to free herself of the strongholds of addiction. One of the many reasons Florence and the Machine continues to enthrall is not only because of Welch's talent, but her resilience through it all. She's a beautiful spirit, making Florence and the Machine one of the best acts in the indie genre. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and comment if you liked today's video. I'll see you soon. As always, I love to read comments. Please leave me one. I'll see you next time. Bye.